This is automated timeline scrolling animation in Premiere Pro. So first, you need to go to the toolbar and select the text tool, and then go to the screen and type in the first year, then press space and type in the next year, and so on. Now to speed up this process, you can ask ChatGPT to do this, and you can simply copy and paste it. Now in effects and tools, expand the text tab, and then resize and reposition the text, so the first year is in the center of the screen. Now to create this scrolling animation, you first need to move to the point where you want it to start, and then click on the stopwatch next to position to create a keyframe. Then move forward to the point where you want to end the animation, and then change the position value so the final year you want to be visible is in the center of the screen. Now select both keyframes, right click, go to temporal interpolation, ease in, and then select ease out. This will smoothen out the animation. And this is how it looks. To customize the speed even further, you can click on this arrow next to position, and then click on one of the keyframes to show these blue handles. Now you can adjust the speed graph to your liking using these controls. And this is how it looks. Now to make only one year visible at a time, you need to click on the pen tool under the text tab, and then create a rectangular mask around the year. And you can also smooth out the edges by increasing the mask feather value in effects and tools. Now for the final touch, we can add some motion blur to the animation. So simply go to effects and then search directional blur, and then apply it to the text layer. And in effects and tools, move to the first position keyframe using this button. And then set the direction to 90 degrees and click on the stopwatch next to the blur length to create a keyframe. Now move forward a little bit and then increase the blur length to around 40. Then move forward just right before the last position keyframe and then create a blur length keyframe. And last but not least, align the player with the last keyframe and then reset the blur length. This is the final result. To learn more about Premiere, click on the video on screen right now. Now see you there.